Hello everyone. Today I'll be talking about the demographic transition theory of population. So here is the introduction of demographic transition theory. So demographic transition is the process of change in a society's population. So it is based upon the trends in mortality, fertility, and natural increase in more developed countries of Europe, North America, and Asia. So demographic transition theory was originated by W.S. Thompson in 1928, and Frank W. Notstein developed it. So here's a definition given by Dolan. Demographic transition refers to a population cycle that begins with a fall in death rate, continues with a phase of rapid population growth, and concludes with a decline in birth rate. Sorry for the spelling mistake here. Next, we have the stages of demographic transition. So there are in total four stages which we take generally. So here is the first stage. So in the first stage, both birth rate and death rate is high. As we can see here, birth rate and death rate both is high. Slow growth rate is seen. Population is stationary. Stage 1 does not exist in present time because death rate has reduced even in the most underdeveloped countries. So here the population is highly stationary. And death rate, this green line denotes the death rate. So it is very high. But this rate of death rate does not exist because the underdeveloped countries also has better medical facilities. So because of this, the death rate is declined. So the first stage is characterized by low productivity, low standard of living, heavy agricultural dependence, primitive means of production, underdeveloped transport system. So next we have stage 2. So stage 2 has rapid population growth due to high birth rate and reduction is death rate. So as there is developed medical facilities, so the death rate will decline or reduce, and birth rate is obviously high. So there is natural increase in population, and the natural increase in population is high, and migration is insignificant because the population increases so much that migration doesn't affect the population of the country in that given period of time. So population here is expanding. So countries with this stage are that of Africa and some countries of Southeastern Asia. So here this is the population growth. In stage 1 it was more or less stationary, and here it's expanding because there is natural increase in population is high. So next we have stage 3. So in stage 3, death rate declines and birth rate falls due to urbanization and industrialization. So in stage 3, death rate declines and the birth rate also falls because of urbanization and industrialization. There is awareness among the people, so that is why the birth rate is declining. So population grows in this stage and birth rate is more than the death rate. It is expanding, but the birth rate is not expanding at the same rate as that of the stage 2. Decrease in infant mortality rate. Mortality is low and stable. Fertility is low but fluctuating. So in this stage there is decrease in infant mortality rate. So fourth, we have declining rate of population growth. As we can see, the population growth is declining here. Some countries like India, China, some Latin American countries and Eastern Europe countries is in this stage of demographic transition. So this stage is also characterized by population explosion because in this stage birth rate is high. Next we have stage 4. So in this stage, there is low birth rate and low death rate. Birth rate is around 15 to 20 per thousand and death rate is almost similar, around 15 to 20 per thousand. So here population growth is low and stationary. Here we can see it's low and stationary. The low birth rate and low death rate results in zero or insignificant growth rate. So because of low birth rate and low death rate, the population growth is insignificant. So countries which have reached this stage are highly urbanized and highly industrialized. So these are the countries like Denmark, Hungary, France, Germany, Norway, Japan, Sweden, Australia and New Zealand. So these are the countries in the stage 4 of the demographic transition model. So next we have the criticism. So first we'll talk about the positive aspects of the theory. So this theory is mostly acceptable. It is very easy to understand as it deals with only three terms: the birth rate, death rate and the population growth. The whole theory is defined by these three terms. So it is based on actual population data of Europe and other developed countries. So it is not based on any imaginary data. It is based on the actual population data. So it helps in the planning process. It helps in the planning process of population for the countries. So here we have some negative aspects. So first one is non-availability of data means difficulty in preparation of graphs. So if data is not available, so there will be problem in the preparation of graph. So we cannot find out the demographic transition model because of that. So second is the difficult to get uniform pattern for all countries. So it is not necessary that all the countries will follow the same growth pattern. Some countries can go from stage 2 to directly to stage 4 and skip the stage 3 in between. Third, we have decline in birth rate in rural and urban areas may vary. That would hamper the overall growth rate. So the conclusion is, despite of all the controversy, it has universal applicability. That means the demographic transition theory of population has universal applicability. It can be applicable to all the countries, as all the countries now at this period of time has some population data. That is, it can be applied everywhere if data is available. So data is definitely available for all the countries, whether it is developed, developing or underdeveloped. So this theory is very much useful. So thank you for watching this video.